you. That's my wonderful sound.
Want to keep our kids in school. We want to keep them out of the juvenile justice system. are the future. This is a no-brainer. This is a no-brainer. You have to invest in your future. So I just wanted to start out by saying that, and I'm very passionate about this. And I have a family of my own. I've got two children. I serve on the school board in my community, so I know what I'm talking about as a school board member. I had this juvenile initiative, which has got several prongs attached to it. So I'm in the same boat. I taught DARE for a few years in our public schools in Minneapolis. I saw the problems coming. I was very concerned. But I'll tell you what, this was a ground-up initiative, and it's working for us. So I hope today that you can take just a piece of this away, if nothing else, to say, we're going to meet in a couple of weeks, and we're going to take key folks from the tables in this room, the people, the movers, and the shakers, and we're going to hold people accountable to these objectives. And I see some young lady over here, but the youth, where's the youth? You need to talk to them. You need to get your youth from your high schools in the room, and you need to find out what they're concerned about. Because it's real easy for us to say, yeah, we think this is best for our kids. Get in the room and have a candid conversation with your high school students and find out what's going on in school. Find out what's going on behind the doors of our schools and get that out. Find out what it's going to do to get them engaged. Because if they're not going to talk with you, and they're not going to talk to you as parents or police or community leaders, this is a lost cause. You have to have them at the table. We have a youth. Congress in Minneapolis, and it's, I couldn't tell you how many kids, it's 100 kids, I think, and they go to the Capitol, and they are visible, and they're visible in community, and they are our community leaders, and the more they get out there, the more kids that join, and the more kids we start moving down that productive road. So, with that, just give you a quick brief over how we got where we're at. Fortunately, you're not here, but proportionally, if you have one juvenile homicide, one young victim killed in the city, it's one too many. That was the passion for what we did in Minneapolis. I think I would key on the second bullet if you can see it up there, but in 2006, leading up to 2006, we had about 43% of our homicide victims were ages 15 to 24. All right, these are our young kids. And you may say, well, in Michigan, you're an adult when you're 17. You're a young adult, and this is the population that we are trying to affect. We had everybody from every level around the table when it started, similar to this. Foundations, big companies, we needed funds, we needed faith-based community, we needed the schools, county attorneys, city attorney, police, and I'll say this about police, because I'm a little biased and because I've been a cop for 25 years, but I'll tell you what, it's the first time in my career where the police sat out there in the crowd, as you are, as part of community. And we were part of trying to solve the problem and not part of the problem. I could sit up in front of a group of people, and what would happen? Hand would come up, and the police would get bashed. They would just lash out at us because of an incident that may have happened in one of our neighborhoods. That has changed. We have not become the center of attention. We have become part of the solution and interjecting and working with the community. So anyway, took everybody across the board, put them in a room, and decided what the what the objectives were. The biggest part, we were viewing this juvenile violence as a health, we took a health approach to it, that it's preventable, all right? Talk about the swine flu and all these things that are going on. Disease, in some cases, are preventable. We're treating this as a public health hazard, if you will, and treating it that way, that it's preventable. So what is it that we're going to use? What is the